Today on Zoom, welcome to the backwards alphabet ring. Z, Y, X, W, C, U, O, V, O, I'm going to show you how to make this mosaic flower pot using small toys and other materials you can find around your house.
Lava gobba dobba. Oh, my wobble dobba hobba.
Funding for Zoom is provided by the National Science Foundation, America's investment in the future, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the Arthur Vining Davis Foundation, and by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you.
Thanks!
Hi, we're the Holy Cross School from Springfield, Mass. Get ready to Zoom!
To make as a present for someone in your family.
But first, we're going to play this game called the Zoomer's Cat. Jody H. of Belleville sent us the directions. I'll show you how to fly, and then I'll show you the rhythm. Okay, I start by saying a word that describes the cat that starts with the letter S. So I could say, the Zoomer's cat is an awesome cat. Then the person next to me has to say a word that describes the cat that starts with the letter B, like, the Zoomer's cat is a big cat. Okay, now I'll show you the rhythm. Okay, so you go, you clap your knees twice, and then you clap your hands twice. So, okay. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. You keep going around the circle. If you can't think of a word that starts with the right letter that describes the cat, you're out. The last person left is the winner. Does that sound fun?
Yeah. Yeah.
The Zoomer's cat is an awesome cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a bashful cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a cool cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a dazzling cat.
The Zoomer's cat is an exciting cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a funny cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a great cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a hysterical cat.
The Zoomer's...
No.
I got lost in the letters.
I couldn't really...
Should I start with I?
Yes.
Okay, so... Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. The Zoomer's cat is an... I couldn't even think of anything.
So, does Matt start with I?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ready?
Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8.
The Zoomer's cat's an intelligent cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a joke-ative cat.
Not
a
joke-ative cat. So, I start with J?
Okay. Wait. I thought I had
something. Oh, it's like, it comes so fast. 5, 6, 7, 8.
The Zoomer's cat is a gent...
No.
Okay,
I don't know.
So I thought
I was going to say genuine.
Okay.
So
I'm K.
Wait. Okay,
yeah,
ready?
The Zoomer's cat is a jolly cat.
The Zoomer's cat is a...
Alien Matt.
Okay, so wait.
Matt.
J. K.
Okay.
count L.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ooh. Okay, ready?
5, 6, 7, 8.
The Zoomer's cat's a kind cat.
The Zoomer's cat's a long cat.
The Zoomer's cat's a marvelous cat.
The Zoomer's cat's a naughty cat.
The Zoomer's cat's a...
If you owned a factory, what would you make?
If I had a factory, I would make special telescopes so people could study space.
Computers, because a lot of people like using them and finding out new stuff.
Clothes for poor people that need them.
If I owned a factory, I would make toys for the homeless people.
I would make horse tech because I like horses.
I would make laptops because I like technology.
I would make food and clothing for poor people because I don't think that it would be fair if we had clothing and support and they don't.
If I had a factory, I would make candy.
I would make satellites so we could learn more about distant planets.
What's that? What's that? What's that? What's that? What's that?
Zoom do. This is a mosaic. A mosaic is made up of different kinds of colored materials, such as glass or stones. They're put together to make a picture or a design. See, like this sunflower. Well, today, I'm going to show you how to make this mosaic flower pot using small toys and other materials you can find around your house. Crystal R. of Shreveport, Louisiana, sent us the idea. And here's what you need. A small plastic flower pot, some non-toxic acrylic latex tile grout. You can find it at a hardware store. A plastic knife to spread your tile grout, and thing to decorate your pot with. I'm using small toys, beads, and confetti. Before you start, think of a design to make onto your flower pot. Your design could be a picture, a pattern, or things all the same size, or things all the same color. And I like this one because it's all shades of pink. Or you could give your flower pot a theme. See, mine is all about the ocean, and I picked the ocean on mine because I saw the colors blue and green, and I thought about the sea. And since I like the sea and I saw the sea animals, I just thought about a sea theme, so that's what I made. I think for my flower pot, I'm going to make a summer theme. Okay, so now that I know what I want, I can get started. You spread some tile grout onto a small section of my flower pot. And don't spread on the whole pot, or else this dries pretty quickly, so you might not get a chance to put on your little small toys. And that's good. Now, when you have a small section of your flower pot, you can press some objects on. And I think I'm going to press on this lizard because you reminds me of someone. Stick you right there. Oh, it's on a banana. Of course, you don't have to keep your objects into the grout. For example, I'm going to press in this star. I'm going to take it out because I like the shape it leaves. When you're done with one section of your flower pot, move on to another section. Then, when you're done with your whole flower pot, let it dry. When you're done, it'll look like this one. Plant a flower in it and give it to a friend as a present.
And I'm 11 years old. I live in Holland. We also call it the Netherlands. And it's very, very flat. I live in a part of Holland where most people, like my dad, are growing bulbs for flowers. This is my room and I like it because I've got a beautiful view of the flowers. A lot of the farmers here grow bulbs for growing flowers like these tulips. They have been growing tulips in Holland for over 200 years. Every one of these flowers is grown out of a big seed called a bulb, like this one. This is the part that the farmers sell sent all over the world, like to the US or Canada. So people can buy the bulbs and plant them in their own gardens and have nice tulips. But right now, to help the bulbs grow bigger, we have to cut off the flowers with this machine. Sometimes I help by going behind the cutting machine and taking off the flowers that the machine missed. If you don't cut off the flowers, the bulb will still grow, but it won't be big enough to sell.
Sometimes I see one of these little ones and I just put them in my hair, like this.
This part of Holland is not only very flat, it's surrounded by the sea, which used to cover the whole area. So the people who were living here built dikes.
This is a dike. It's a very big wall they made many, many years ago to keep out the sea. It's covered with grass. How do you like our lawnmowers?
After they built the dikes, there were a lot of shells left in the soil where the sea had been. After a very long time, the shells turned to chalk, and bulbs grow best in chalky soil. We're on the coast of the North Sea, which keeps this part of Holland a little less cold in the winter and a little less hot in the summer. That's good for the flower bulbs. Flower bulbs like a temperate climate. It's cold in the winter, but not too cold, and warm in the summer, but not too hot. That is why we've been growing flower bulbs here for so long. Because of the chalky soil and the temperate climate, there's really no place better than Holland for growing flower bulbs.
So remember, next time when you see a nice tulip, then maybe the bulb came from right here where I live.
Hey, Max!
Yes?
If fruit grows from a fruit tree, what does a chicken grow from?
I don't know.
A poultry! Get it?
How do trees celebrate a birthday party?
I don't know.
They throw a lumber party.
Hey, Matt.
Hi.
What kind of tree doesn't like to play checkers?
I don't know.
A chestnut.
Matt.
Hello.
What month do trees hate the most?
I don't know.
We know that plants need water to grow, make seeds, and stay healthy.
Well, Renee M. of Washington, D.C. told us a way we can see how different parts of the flower get water. Here are some white carnations. And here's what a white carnation looks like when we put it in water and food coloring. See how the water travels up the stem to the petals of the flower? That's called transpiration.
Here's what you'll need to make this at home. Some white flowers. And a container with food coloring and water. First, you cut off a piece of the stem from the flower.
You cut it here and cut it.
If you cut it sideways, I think it will work better.
Yeah,
it'll
get more exposed.
Then you put into the container of water and food coloring.
There we go.
Check every few hours to see how your petals are changing colors. This will only work if the water travels up the stem to the petals. After one day, your petals should go from white to the color of the food coloring, like this.
Here's why this works. The leaves and the petals of the flowers have small little holes called stomates.
They're too small to see. So the water evaporates through these filaments. When the water evaporates, then the plant needs more water to grow. This is called transpiration.
If your flowers are planted in soil like this one, the roots of the flower will suck up water from the soil and go up the stem. If the flowers are put in a pitcher like this one, there are no roots, so the stem just sucks up the water and goes up the stem.
Earlier, we did a little experiment. We wanted to find out what would happen if we changed the temperature of the water. So, we set up two containers with the same amount of water and food coloring and put a flower in each one. We put one container in the refrigerator and the other in room temperature for the same time.
Our prediction was that the flower in the refrigerator would work the best because the water would evaporate faster from the flower.
So let's see if our prediction was right.
Okay, so I'll take this one.
Oh, it looks so pretty.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Ooh. Okay.
There we go.
Oh. The one from that was in room temperature was the best.
Yeah.
Because look at the colors. Mm-hmm. It's a big difference. This one's so much bright and vibrant.
This one's kind of doesn't have as much.
So this one, the water must evaporate faster?
Yeah, it must evaporate faster in warmer water than in cold.
We were wrong, but yeah. I think it was a good guess.
Mm-hmm.
So next time you see a flower that doesn't look its natural color, you'll know how it's made. Like a green carnation for St. Patrick's Day. Here's how you can make a flower with two different colors. Split the stem in half and put it into two different containers of food coloring, like this.
Now it's your turn to experiment. Think of a question you want answered, like, what would happen if you put the flower in sugar water? Make a prediction.
Here's how you can test it out. Take three flowers and put them into three containers of water. The water should all be the same amount in each container, and there should be the same amount of food coloring. One with lots of sugar, one with little sugar, and one with no sugar. Make some observations, then send your results to Zoom.
Welcome
to
the
Backwards
Alphabet
Race. And it was emailed to us by Amy A. of Billerica, Massachusetts. The object of the game is to say the alphabet backwards in the least amount of time. So here's what you'll do. You split up into two teams and line up. Right.
Okay, so...
Okay. Oh, whoops.
Blue will go over here.
Oh. Okay.
So, the first person on the team would say Z, the second player would say Y, and the third person would say X, and so on. If a player messes up, then the other team gets a turn. The first team to say the alphabet backwards in the least amount of time first wins. All right, so you guys go first.
Okay, I'm going to start.
Okay. Are you ready? Mm-hmm. On your mark, get set, go.
Z.
Y.
X.
W.
T.
U.
Z.
It's your turn.
Okay,
ready?
Sorry.
Ready?
Z. Y.
X.
W.
V.
U.
T.
F.
R.
Q.
You can do it. Come on, lady.
It's okay. You'll have another turn if you can.
R.
No.
Sorry. Your team. Okay, blue team.
Okay. Z.
Y.
F.
W.
P.
No. T.
Okay, I'll get it next time.
Red team.
Z.
Z.
Y.
F.
W.
V.
U.
T.
S.
R.
Q.
T.
O.
N.
M.
L.
Got it, Garrett.
K.
I.
No.
Oh, we did good. Okay, here we go.
Z.
Y.
W,
V,
U,
T,
Got it.
S? Yes. R.
Q.
P?
Yes. O.
N.
N. L.
K.
J.
I.
H.
G.
Yes.
F.
E.
D.
C.
B.
I.
Good job. Good job, you guys.
Geneva in Kenan B of Placidas, New Mexico.
There seems to be a tornado in Texas.
Really? But it says here that there's going to be earthquake in New Mexico.
Of the Zoom team who helped clean up their communities. Selena, Isabel, Julia, and Rebecca of Newton, Massachusetts cleaned up a playground. First, they picked up the trash. Then they hung a sign on a fence that says, "Please keep our park clean." Next, they're going to have a bake sale to raise money to buy plants for the playground. Holly, Sam, and Brady of Soldotna, Alaska also helped clean up their neighborhood. In just 2 hours, they filled up 3 bags full of trash. Excellent job, Zoom teamers. Is there a lot of trash in your neighborhood? Well, if there is, why don't you organize a neighborhood cleanup? And be sure to tell us about it at the Zoom into Action section of the Zoom website.
Zoom into Action! And join the Zoom team!
Cover tabu abba bubby dubba bubby bubba rubby tabel abba nubba love us abba bubba subbo abba jubbeck abba nubba bubby stubbock jubbeck trubby dubba dubbis cub out bubba subba mubba jubbeck bubbing love it tubby wubba hubba bubbins wubba nubby rubbings abba bubbing tubba om tabu abba's mubba dubba
wubbock mubba mubba jubbeck bubbings
yabba trubby dubba abba cub out
Bubba bobbins? Bubba mubbum! Dubber mubba jubbick bobbins!
Love it, Savvy.
Savo Jabba, Clubba, and the Bubbin Stubba, Abba, 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 Abba,
by love of loving me, Abu Zabek.
Love a cup of Zabek. Oh, my love, Zabek, Havarp.
Become the property of Zoom and will be eligible for inclusion in all Zoom media.
This means that we can share your ideas with other Zoomers on TV, the web, in print materials, and in other media.
So, send it to Zoom.
America's investment in the future.
The Corporation for Public Broadcasting.
The Arthur Vining Davis Foundation.
And by contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you.
Thanks!